I was born in Vyshinskaya. It is a small but beautiful village in the south part of Russia, close to the Ukrainian border. I grew up in a family where we always had love, joy, and happiness. My parents were common people. They don't have any university degree, but they gave me the most important lessons in my life. They always taught me, whatever you do, you have to do with all your heart and love. No matter what education or position you have, the most important to be a good person. In Russia, we had beautiful and successful life. My husband was a judge. I was a vice president and the head of legal department of a huge corporation. We traveled several times a year around the world. I could spend all my summer with my kids near the sea. And we never dreamed of immigration anywhere. But one day, our life in Russia became impossible for us. In 2014, the war between Russia and Ukraine began, and the political situation changed a lot. People who expressed their opinion about the war and government were persecuted, and we were one of them. After somebody twice shut our windows, we realized that there is no choice, we had to go. In that period, we had an American tourist visa, and America was the only one country where we can legally immigrate to. Unfortunately, my parents did not have any visa at all, and they could not go with us. It was the hardest decision of my life. I had to choose between my children and my parents, whom I love very much. But here we are in November 2016, we came to the United States of America seeking asylum. America greeted us with beautiful holiday season. We came before Thanksgiving. In Russia, we have no such a holiday, but you know how this holiday is important for American people. We saw these huge preparations everywhere. It was really beautiful time. And we saw happy people surrounded us. We had no any relatives and friends here, and we really felt so lonely here. And I was dreaming about to celebrate this holiday in American family. I really wanted to find new friends. I really wanted to know more about American culture. From my friend Karen, I learned about excellent internet resource, which is called Nextdoor, where I posted the introduction about my family, added some family photos. People were so welcoming and friendly. Some of them offered us furniture, some of them kitchen stuff. But one day we received a letter from an American couple who invited us to celebrate the Thanksgiving with them. And it was like a miracle. I just dreamed about it and it became true. It was great evening. It was an American traditional dinner with turkey, mashed potatoes, corn, cranberry sauce. Pies. We brought some Russian food as well. These people were not our relatives, but I really felt like I was a part of this family. And no matter how much food we ate, but it was a real moment to realize how we were grateful for everything we had. After Thanksgiving, the Christmas was around the corner. In Russia, we have such a holiday, but we celebrate in a different way, in a different time. One day, somebody knocked on our door. I opened the door and saw a woman. She introduced herself as Melody. She brought us Christmas decorations. It was beautiful Christmas decorations we ever had before. She showed us the American way how to celebrate Christmas. Next day, she brought all my family to the Christmas tree farm, and we cut our own real tree. It was first our Christmas in America, and it was the best Christmas we ever had before. But it was not only life of joy and happiness. We were new to this country, and it was time of pain and difficulties, challenges. We came with a great education. I have a PhD degree in law. We came with a huge experience, working experience, but here in America, we had to start our life again. All of this didn't matter anymore. We were seeking for any job opportunity, even for dirty job. And I can tell you, without language, without work experience, it was so difficult to find any job. But we were in such a need that we really were so grateful for any job, any side work. We worked at the farm, we cleaned houses, we took any opportunity to make money to provide our children safe house and food. It was really so hard. But right now, I'm a program manager at Russian Oregon Social Services. Our agency was established 25 years ago by Ecumenical Ministry of Oregon. We provide services to Russian immigrants, help them to increase their independence, self-sufficiency, health and well-being. And I really love my job because helping my community, it brings me feeling that I'm helping my family, whom I can't help right now. I mean my parents. Just recently, we celebrated the International Women's Day, and you should know how important this holiday in Russia. We celebrate women's achievements in the society. And in Russia, I always visited my mom with flowers. But right now, it's impossible for us because we are so far from each other. I organized a party for our participants who are survivors of domestic and sexual violence. I really wanted to make their day more special and remarkable for them. I addressed floral businesses, and they kindly donated us a lot of beautiful flowers. I arrived at my work and with car full of gorgeous flowers. I called my mom using Skype so she can see all these flowers, and I told her, "I love you, Mom, and I'm so grateful for all lessons you gave me in my life." She cried. I cried also, and she told me, "I love you so much, and I'm proud of you, and I raised a good person." And despite all difficulties, America became home to me, to my husband, to my children, and we are looking forward for the bright future in our new home.